Mike, shortly after the Japanese earthquake and subsequent disasters on 3/11, CSIS organized a task force with our Japanese partner, Keidanren, to examine the ways for the U.S. and Japan to partner on the recovery for the Japanese people. How did this come about, and who all was involved with it?
We have a longstanding cooperative relationship with Keidanren, Japan's business federation, and a visiting fellow from Keidanren. And we proposed to them that we put together a task force to look at ways how the U.S. could help in the recovery and reconstruction process, and in the process strengthen our relationship and broaden the cooperation between different sectors. And Keidanren said yes. We asked Jim McInerney, the CEO of Boeing, to chair it, and he said yes right away. And we stood it up on April 11th and started doing some serious work in different areas.
So what, without divulging any of the findings of the report yet, we've been awed in the United States by the remarkable perseverance of the Japanese people in the face of this tragedy. And you know, I know that you've been doing a lot of thinking about how the United States can do more to help Japan during this difficult period of recovery. Can you give us some of these insights?
Sure. I mean, we came away from this whole experience with an even deeper respect for the Japanese people, especially the people we met in Tohoku, who are many of them officials at the local level who are literally living in their cars because their houses have been destroyed, who have in some cases lost their families, who are working around the clock, helping people, making plans for recovery. It really impressed all of us. We were impressed by a lot of the technology we learned about. The bullet train in Japan, traveling well over 200 miles an hour, received warnings electronically and hit the brakes 3 seconds after the earthquake hit. And they were stopped before the waves even hit the coastline. Remarkable technology, nothing like it in the world. So we saw some real strengths in Japanese society and Japanese technology. Their disaster preparedness and response was top shelf, our experts concluded. But this disaster also hit where Japan's having a lot of struggles. An aging society, well over half of the victims were 65 or older. A tough fiscal situation, 200% debt to GDP ratio. Now they gotta finance this. We think they can, but it's a big challenge. We looked a bit at what would attract investment in terms of trade liberalization, and TPP, the Trans-Pacific Partnership, this trade liberalizing deal in Asia, is a big political football in Japan. There's a debate about whether or not they should join, but we heard pretty universally, if you want to attract investment in this region, if you want to keep Japanese companies here, you got to liberalize trade. And so we recommended that. We looked at security. The U.S. and Japan combined rescue operation, Operation Tomodachi, which means friend in Japanese. Biggest combined operation we've ever done with Japan. So we didn't just look at how the U.S. and Japan can help recover and rebuild in Tohoku, but how this experience can make Japan and the U.S. better partners in a variety of fields and help to revitalize Japan's critically important role in international affairs. In Asia, at the UN, and in the international institutions more broadly.
Were we also able to learn some of our own issues for the United States about preparing for disasters and indeed for the recovery afterwards?
Out of this task force, there are a lot of partnerships that are starting to build. So for example, Randy Martin led our working group on civil society and NGO, lessons learned. Japan has a small NGO community. They did really well. It so impressed Mercy Corps that they are now basing Randy Martin in Japan to work with the Japanese on coming out of this experience so we can do disaster relief together elsewhere in Asia. Steve Morrison, leading the global health exercise, has generated so much interest from Merck and Kaiser Permanente and the Gates Foundation and others that he's got an ongoing dialogue now on a couple of key areas: mental health, and also dealing with long-term radiation leakage that will go on for years. We're going to go to Fukushima and do a seminar, for example. And then Louisiana State University, Tohoku University are talking about collaboration on disaster learning. So that's a lot of what we wanted to do with the task force was create a lot of linkages and ongoing dialogue that will help Japan recover, but really help us strengthen our partnership and help others facing similar challenges.
Remarkable story. Mike Green, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.